that through this mystery, your servant Paul, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Tommy, but do you want to do the reading that you see like that? It's independent from the program.
Isaiah 41:10-13. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. For I, the Lord your God, hold your right hand. It is I who say to you, fear not, I am the one who helps you.
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Ecclesiastes 3:1-2. For everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck what is planted. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel affirmation. Hallelujah. 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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit on his glorious throne. Then the king will say to those on his right, come, you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you? Or thirsty and give you something to eat? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go to visit you? Then the king will reply, truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these my brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me. The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Now, divine master, may you let your servant rest in peace. For our eyes have seen the salvation which you have won for all people. Please be seated. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Tom, and now we have come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will despise in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in faith in Jesus Christ. Now, we invite you to please sing the song of farewell. I know that my Redeemer's name. You know that? I know that my Redeemer's live, and on that final day of days, his voice shall bid me rise again on any joy unceasing praise. This hope I cherish in my heart, to stand on earth my fresh resolve. angel for a friend. Behold my Savior and my Lord. Saints of our God, come unto his aid. Angels of God, receive his soul. May Christ who call you to himself present him now to God most high. Eternal rest grant unto him. Angels of God, receive his soul. May Christ who call him to himself eternal rest grant unto I lose of my redeemed away. The resurrection of the Lord. Take the eternal rest to God we pray. Into your hands, Father of mercy, we commend our brother Tommy Lee Gibson in a sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestow upon Tom in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful God, turn towards us and listen to our prayer. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Now, Divine Master, may you let your servant rest in peace. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We have come to the end of this segment of the liturgy of Final Communion. We ask God's peace to be with the family. May God be with you on this journey. Know that your dad will always live on in you, that he is with the Lord. Now one day, all of us too will be with him in that place that Christ has prepared for us. Let us now go in peace. Thanks be to God.
The family, on behalf of the staff here in Georgia National Cemetery and also the Department of Veterans Affairs, I want to offer you guys our deepest condolences on the loss of your loved one. What happened next is our field group will come by the shelter and take your loved one to his final resting place. The family will not be present for the second part of the interment, but you guys are welcome to come back today after 4:30. Your loved one will be laid to rest today in section 10, gravesite number 1378. Once again, family, section 10, gravesite number 1378. Family, once again, on behalf of the staff here at Georgia National Cemetery, my condolences to you all.
On behalf of Emily Walker, Gina Home and staff, we thank you for entrusting us with Mr. Gibson. We pray our service will to your satisfaction as far as their aim has been accomplished. At this time, I pray that God will give each of you traveling mercy, healing, and peace of grace. At this time, may stand and return to your father.